eyes are on the latest COVID case numbers, less than 24 hours from the next alert level decision. Today there were 20 new cases, bringing the total outbreak so far to 922. 352 of those have now recovered, meaning 570 are still active. Of those, 18 are in hospital, 4 in specialist care units. But it's the behaviour of two Aucklanders this weekend that's raising serious concerns for the rest of the country. Katie Bradford's with us now. What have these people done, Katie?
Well, in a move that's probably going to anger a lot of people and that police describe as calculating and deliberate. A young couple from Auckland who had essential worker status went to the border, got permission, crossed over, drove to Hamilton and then flew to their holiday home in Wanaka. Now, police discovered this and have charged them under the health order that's currently in place. They could face up to 6 months in jail or a $4,000 fine and will appear in court later this week. Police have told me this afternoon that they have said they will return to their usual residence here in Auckland, but police say they will check up on them to make sure that happens. They say this is disappointing, giving so many of us a sacrificing so much to keep the country safe. And we spoke to Queenstown Mayor Jim Bolt this afternoon.
These people are endangering the health of folk in our part of the world and our livelihoods because, you know, this puts us in the position where we could end up like Auckland. Very disappointing.
And, of course, with an alert level decision later this week, there's a lot of concerns about things like these. Police say also this weekend three people were stopped at the border. They'd falsified an essential worker letter and tried to get through. And over 600 people have been charged with offences since alert level 4 began. Now, Cabinet is, of course, making that last-minute decision tomorrow afternoon. All eyes on whether Auckland will be able to return, go down a level and what that means for the rest of the country. But it's incidents like this that put the rest of country at risk.
A sunny day drawing Aucklanders to the beaches and parks for a chance to stretch their legs. Most wearing masks, but it's the few rule breakers who could ruin it for everyone else.
People just want to get back to normal.
Even in like countdown places like that, still a lot of people are congregating when maybe they shouldn't be.
I don't think complacent, I think people are getting a little kind of over it.
These testing centres were mostly empty today, and while there's been targeted testing in some suburbs, there's still a call for more to get swabbed. Out of the 922 cases so far, 34 are unlinked. Health authorities concerned about a handful of those.
No widespread community transmission in Auckland. And yes, we have seen a few cases which over the last week or so, which taken us a bit of time to link. Therefore, we're assuming there may be other undetected cases.
Mm. Aucklanders desperate for takeaways will be eagerly waiting for Cabinet's decision tomorrow. But if our biggest city remains at level 4, it's unlikely anywhere else will get level 1 freedoms.
One of the things that I will be considering when we receive the advice is just the relative risk to the rest of the country when we still have an active outbreak in Auckland.
In the background, there's a level of infection and outbreak that we can't get our arms around. We have seen this overseas.
This modeller pointing out the South Auckland community will need support for some time yet.
Where life is difficult and they lack the sorts of institutions such as churches to support them. And then that's when it spreads and that's when you get these background cases and that's where things like level 4 struggle to work.
Back at the beach, most are taking lockdown in their stride.
We have no option. We need to respect and stay at home.
Get vaccinated, just get on with it.
I'd like to say optimistic, but unfortunately I'm feeling like we're probably not going to be going to level 3.
Whatever decision they make, I fully stand by.
We have to do what we have to do.
The team of 1.6 million wanting to rejoin the team of 5 million ASAP. Katie Bradford, One News.